दिखाओ।
नहीं दिखा। इसको पकड़ के बोला।
हाँ वो मैं लगा दूँ। Good morning. I am JVN Dr. Lily Trivedi, and today the lecture I am going to give to you is on post-harvest pathology of the subject MSc Botany 3rd SEM in the discipline Food and Biotechnology. During post-harvest phase of food production, production loss may occur as a result of improper harvest practices, rough handling of fruits, inadequate storage facilities, poor packaging. Also, the wounds caused by the above factors may pave way for the infection of harvested fruits by microorganisms, especially bacteria and fungi. The plant products may get infected by microorganisms and cause rotting or decay, partially or totally. The quality of the fruit and the plant products become reduced due to the above infection. The seeds and grains may get damaged by accumulation of toxic substances. The mycotoxin produced by infected microorganisms. The fleshy fruits, vegetables, etc. like tomato, banana, citrus, strawberries, rhizome of ginger, bulb of onion, tuber of potato, etc. may get damaged. This results in the reduction of quantity and quality or both of the affected parts or the plant products as a whole. The amount or the extent of damage depends mainly on the pathogens involved or on the condition of the product and the condition of the storage. The pathogens involved are mainly fungi like Pythium, Phytophthora, Rhizopus, Aspergillus, etc. and some bacteria like Pseudomonas, Erwinia, etc. Here we can see the infected fruit of papaya and the infected potato tuber. The two types of post-harvest diseases, disease of dry bulk materials such as seeds and grains, and diseases of fleshy storage organs such as vegetables, tubers, rhizomes, bulbs, etc. and fruits. The real cause of the spoilage of vegetables and fleshy fruits in transit and also in the storage is due to high moisture, high temperature and injuries caused during marketing. Due to high moisture content and nutrient in the harvested vegetables and fruits, they are vulnerable to attack by pathogenic organisms. The injuries of fruits and vegetables may be caused during harvesting, packing and transposition. They help the pathogen to enter the host and cause damage. But the seeds and grains can be stored for a long time due to low moisture content, about 12 to 14%, where most of the pathogens cannot grow favorably. Diseases of stored seeds and food grains. Field fungi like Alternaria, Fusarium, Cladosporium, Verticillium, Helminthosporium and Colletotrichum etc. attack seeds and grains on growing crops, but they are unable to grow in storage due to low relative humidity, that is below 90 degrees. During storage or transit, the seeds and the grains are damaged by different species of Aspergillus and Penicillium, which grow well at relative humidity ranges from 70 to 90%. The commonly available Aspergillus species are Aspergillus repens, Aspergillus ruber, Aspergillus flavus, Aspergillus candidus, etc. Aspergillus and a number of other storage fungi invade the embryo of the seeds and the grains and they discolor the embryo or the seeds as a whole. Thereby, the germination percentage reduces markedly. In some cases, the spoilage of the storage grains and seeds results in drastic increase of temperature up to 70 degrees centigrade or more, which encourage the growth of different thermophilic and thermotolerant fungi such as Aspergillus fumigatus, Absidia species, Mucor pulsillus, etc. In addition to storage fungi, the other microorganisms may grow in or on seeds and accelerate the deterioration process. During breeding period of insects, the moisture content and temperature of seeds increase. Thereby, rapid growth of pathogen takes place, producing enormous amount of spores. During storage, the fungi produce mycotoxins that cause great damage to both domestic animals and human beings. The important fungi in this respect are Aspergillus and Penicillium, which produce aflatoxin and other toxins. The most important toxins are yellow rice toxin produced by the grains of rice, barley, etc. by species of Penicillium. Tremorgenic toxins produced on prepared food during storage in refrigeration or in other places and also on food produced from infected grains and seeds. Penicillic acid, it is a carcinogenic substance produced by different species of both Aspergillus and Penicillium in molded cereal grains. Control. The above mentioned loss or damage by the decay and spoilage of seeds and or grains by storage fungi can be controlled by the following procedures. Low moisture. The moisture content of the rooms for storage should be kept below 70 degrees. Low temperature. The temperature in storehouse should be maintained below 30 degrees because most of the storage fungi can grow well at temperature between 30 to 55 degrees. Ventilation. Proper ventilation should be maintained during storage and also during holding period before sending to the market. Sanitation. Proper sanitation should be maintained to keep the storage products clean. Use of insecticide. Insecticides like methyl bromide and some other fumigants are used to treat the harvest seeds and thereby regulate the storage fungi and reduce economic loss. Clean. Clean, uninjured and properly ripened seeds should be selected for storage. Then only they will be able to resist the action of the storage pathogens. The disease can also be controlled or reduced following the preventive procedures, which are: the fruits and vegetables should be harvested and handled carefully to avoid any injury which may facilitate the pathogen to cause infection. The infected regions on the vegetable should be cut off to avoid further infection during transportation and storage. The storage containers, warehouses, etc. should be properly cleaned with copper sulfate, formaldehyde, etc. to avoid contamination. The temperature should be stored, the crop should be stored or transported at a temperature low enough to slow down the development of disease. Proper ventilation in storage reduces the spread of further development of disease. The crop should be free from insects and other pests. Thus, creation of new wounds and disease can be avoided. Hot water and hot air treatment help to reduce further the spread of the disease. Chemical control. The post-harvest disease may be controlled by the application of thiabendazole, dichloran, dosash, etc. These chemicals help to prevent the infection and suppress the development of pathogen on the host surface. Some other chemicals such as vapors of acetaldehyde, biphenyl, nitrogen chloride forming chemicals, etc. are used as supplementary measures to control the post-harvest diseases during the storage and transportation. I hope this lecture was very helpful to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
ठीक ऐसे ये शोल्डर वोल्डर डाला करो फिर पूरा नाम।